Some things in life are absolutely guaranteed. Taxes, death, and the creation of more SCPs. Since the inception of the foundation, hundreds of new creations have been fired into the spotlight every year, and now we're at a number that surpasses 6,000. Needless to say, this series could go on for a while. And it has. Hitting part 24 is insane, considering how many SCP monsters we've managed to talk about. But we've got to keep moving forward, even higher in the number we'll discuss. There's always something new to discover when it comes to the good old SCP Wiki, so let's get to it. The top 5 SCP monsters that can never escape, part 24. Coming in at number 5, we've got SCP-4335. Damn, lockdown's gonna make this one terrifying again. Like, what did a whole bunch of folks, including myself, do during that extended period of time indoors? Well, what any sane person would do, get back into Minecraft. Big time. Is this relatable? I know me and my friends did this, but is it true for everyone else? Regardless, you can't deny the popularity and cultural impact of Mojang's block building simulator. Hell, this recent milk crate trend gives off Minecraft vibes at this point, but I digress. We're here to talk about SCPs, aren't we? And this one is a doozy and a half. SCP-4335 is a strange, unexplainable entity that resides within Minecraft. Folks who stumble across it tend to end up pretty freaked out, and for good reason. It looks like someone took a classic Minecraft skin and colored it all black. No face, no features, no garments, just the darkest of dark colors. For reasons beyond our understanding, it also has a cloud of black smoke particles around its form at all times. Sometimes you might catch a glimpse of yellow eyes or a white mouth, but it's not too often that this happens. Sprouting from its back, we've got a set of black tentacles, akin to those one might associate with Slenderman. It really does sound like something born from a mediocre Minecraft creepypasta, but it goes deeper than that. This form isn't just something that goes around griefing people and spooking them with hyper-realistic eyes and blood. This SCP has a goal, and seems pretty good at achieving it. It will move from server to server, often private or single player ones, whenever it pleases. And if anyone goes into creative mode, it hops to a new server too. Somehow, this entity, born within the game, has learned that it is a creation of humans, or humanity. It wants out so that it can live a life outside of these bounds. However, it has also decided that humans aren't worthwhile creatures and are motivated by unseemly things. Because of this, SCP-4335 wants to destroy humanity. It has a power that's hard to describe, as outside of a game world it doesn't really make all that much sense. It can create in a way that humans cannot, and it's striving to escape from the digital realm into our own. If and when that happens, things could get very hairy for us reality dwellers. Coming at number 4, we've got SCP-5764. When you navigate to this SCP's entry on the wiki, you'll be presented with only one prompt. Unlike most other pages from the Foundation's files, this one does not feature a classification or a set of containment procedures, just a little bit of text. In red, clickable text, you'll see the words, "Don't click." For those of you who don't want something very heavy weighing on your mind, I'd suggest you follow these instructions. You can stick around if you're curious as to how this one works, as only I have to really experience it to get the idea across. There aren't any cognitohazards or inherent dangers here, but when you click that first prompt, a whole new story opens up. Keep clicking and you'll be responsible for what happens. Alright, you ready to hear what goes on in this entry? If, as a defiant little rat, you click "don't click," you'll be greeted by another clickable piece of text. This one says, "There is nothing here." But you can click it, and if you do that, you'll get another reading, "There is nothing here." Of course, folks are going to want to keep clicking at this point. If you do so, you get to more emphatically worded pleas not to click, then some threats concerning what might happen to you if you continue, but eventually, whatever presence is behind this text relents. They begin talking to you through the information in the clickable text. Apparently, they didn't exist until that page was opened, and they will continue existing until you reach the end of the entry. So the more you click and interact with SCP-5764, the closer this entity inches towards death. It's a real emotional roller coaster, with the thing starting out angry, then sad, and then happy that it has someone to communicate with before it goes. Apparently this has happened many times, and the entity knows it will happen again. But the more people that complete this ritual, the shorter its time is before being erased and restarted. At the very end, it bids you adieu, and then you're finally brought to the actual containment procedures. These state that the SCP is an anomaly that affects this page, and every time someone visits it, it gains sentience, and every time they leave the page, it loses it. It can't go anywhere, as the page seems to contain it, so yeah, it can never escape. Folks who read this are also encouraged not to visit the page again, for the sake of the entity. Coming in at number 3, we've got SCP-3426. We could very well be screwed by this hard to define SCP. It might have something to do with the pattern screamers, and if you're unsure as to what those are, maybe stay in the dark. Some knowledge is better left unlearned. Or you could watch our video featuring them, but that is up to you. SCP-3426 is a phenomenon responsible for the total extinction of a technologically and socially advanced planetary civilization. What exactly that means is still up in the air. It could be an event, an entity, a concept, or many other vague things. Nobody's really come up with a way to properly define it. However, we do know a lot of the characteristics required for the phenomena to begin. And now that I'm thinking about it, we're not in trouble. Earth is much too primitive a planet to be concerned with destruction like this. 3426 focuses on highly advanced civilizations, ones who have figured out an indefinitely sustainable energy source, perfected space travel, and developed a unified theory of the universe. We're a little bit off from that, eh? And interestingly enough, having an organization like the Foundation is also a prerequisite. If these and a few more criteria are met, it begins. Anomalous material corrosion, reality distortion, and corruption of information media spread across the planet, eventually wiping out all intelligent life. Many planets have already fallen to this phenomena, which we have discovered through some very clever usage of drones and probes. For now, we don't meet the advanced criteria, so we're safe. But it seems we're constantly moving towards a future where we might, so keep an eye out. Coming in at number 2, we've got SCP-6223, the good old fire and brimstone radio program, a staple of American horror literature for ages. What's scarier than driving through some backwoods area where all anyone ever listens to is a radio show that paints you as the devil? Better be careful where you stop to eat, right? Well, this radio show is a little more anomalous than your average brainwashing broadcast. It seems to find a way to communicate directly with the sinners it designates and ensures that they have the worst possible time while trying to escape. Headed by DJ Slimy, SCP-6223 is a broadcast that plays in all sorts of backwater places. He fields calls from people looking to confess their sins, although he plays no part in absolving them. This holy broadcaster believes firmly that there is no heaven, that pop culture has sold people the idea of it to push out more products. Nope, hell is the only option for anyone, and finding a nice cozy place in the lake of fire is all that one can hope for. Then he ensures that any listeners are going to join him there by influencing all those around to rip and tear and maim anyone who passes through with a guilty conscience. And the more you listen, the more you hear yourself in the proceedings. It's designated safe, but the doctor investigating swears that one of the people heard on the broadcast sounds just like her. And finally, at number 1, we've got SCP-6002. The world we live in is constantly changing, and we have a whole lot to do with that. Humans have probably had the largest impact on the planet Earth than any other living being since the dawn of time. We build, we destroy, we conquer. A lot of stuff gets swept under the rug as a result. Ever heard of an A-turn? Didn't think so. SCP-6002 is what we can only assume is the tree of life. From here, all life sprouts. Like Yggdrasil in Norse mythology, this tree is the symbol of all that is living, and if it were to be destroyed, the rest of life would follow. It seems that the Foundation discovered such a tree in the early 20th century and decided that its traditional wards were not doing enough with it, so they assigned some doctors to it and began research. Bad call all around, as they soon discovered. Every branch of this tree represents a species of living creature, and sometimes even concepts of life and health. If a branch representing an entire breed of dogs were to be broken off, that type of dog would die out entirely. This did end up happening, and the Foundation quickly erased the fact from the common consciousness. But it doesn't seem that they stopped there. An entire classification of living beings, A-turns, seems to be missing from everyone's memory. But if the entry on the wiki is to be believed, A-turns did once exist, and some meddling with SCP-6002 deleted them entirely. It could happen to any living species, too. For now, it seems to be mostly under control, but some high-ranking Foundation scientists are dead set on continuing research. Any small mistake could have massive repercussions, so cross your fingers and hope that they don't accidentally phase out your favorite animal, or worse yet, every animal. The years start coming and they don't stop coming, right? Same with SCPs. I'm sure that some of the monsters seemed a little less monstrous today, but I assure you they've all got the capacity to cause some serious problems, so they'd better not escape. What'd you think of the list? Do you agree with my picks? Which SCP is your favorite? Make sure you let me know down in the comments. I'm running out of time here, so we'll do some comment replies next time. I'm gonna go start using leaded products again in my day-to-day life. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.